Slot hier im Zelt. Wer von den anwesenden Hackern hat denn heute schon Koffein?
Okay, welcome to this translation of this talk about caffeine.
Handvoll, vielleicht zwei Handvoll, eigentlich alle. Wenig überraschend,
and ich glaube, Koffein. Who here in the audience has consumed any caffeine today? Basically, everyone in the audience raised their hands. So, as caffeine is such an integral part of being a hacker, I'm very happy to announce the next speaker who will talk about everything you always wanted to know about caffeine, or maybe didn't want to know.
Hallo liebe Menschen, danke,
hello,
dass ihr hier
and
seid
welcome.
Und in diesem Zelt ist, statt euch an den See zu setzen.
I'm glad you're here in this tent and not at the lake. I'm happy to be talking about caffeine today and I'm interested in that and I'm consuming a lot of caffeine myself, so I was thinking this might be a very interesting topic, which is also interesting to a lot of you. So while I was preparing for this talk, I looked at my own caffeine consumption, and on the bottom you see the date, and on the left side you see the amount of caffeine I was taking in. And right now that might not mean a lot to you, but we can see later what this means actually. So here we are seeing what types of caffeine I was consuming, and I was consuming about 10 liters of caffeine, and that's around 2,000 milligrams of caffeine, and my favorite drink was Miu Miu Mate Ginger. And so I brought a Flora Mate with me, which I don't have in this graph, but I can enjoy it now. So let's first of all look at the molecule itself. You can look, see it here, it's cute, and it's not very complicated. So in its original form, it's not very interesting, actually. And if you look at it, it looks a lot like powdered sugar. And I think all of you know how this looks like. And the first extrapolated caffeine was actually from coffee beans. And Goethe was interested, what is the stimulating thing coming out of coffee? And he extrapolated this molecule and was researching on this. And theine, you might have heard about this, is basically the same thing as caffeine. Sometimes you have a this differentiated because of the things it's coming out of, but the like official name, chemistry name here is 1,3,7 trimethyl 3,7 dihydro 1H purine 2,6 dione. I don't know this official name by heart, I just call it caffeine. If you
ja, die am häufigsten bekannte Wirkung des Koffeins ist, dass sie uns wach macht. Und
so, if you look at what it is doing and what the effects are, the most well-known effect is that it makes us awake. And that's what we all use it for, mostly. And so the lethal dose of caffeine is 10 grams, and that sounds like a lot, and in your daily consumptions you won't really hit this dose. So let's look at the effects caffeine has. And we all drink it because we want to be happy and energized and start our days this way. And the main effect of caffeine is
the main effective method, how it works, is it goes to the receptor of adenosine in your brain, and it can raise your blood pressure and your heart rate. It can make it easier to breathe for you, and it can make you more effective. It can increase your concentration. It can increase your level of being awake. So let's look at how it actually works. In our brain, all of us have these synapses. The synapses are basically how the body regulates what we need at each point and how it works. Caffeine basically goes where adenosine usually goes. Adenosine we have in our body, it's something that develops from ATP, adenosine triphosphate, and whenever we use something, we use energy in our body, what happens is that ATP is getting split up into adenosine, among others. And that kind of leads to me getting tired when I have a lot of adenosine, like the cat here. The adenosine makes sure that our body doesn't split out any more adrenaline, and it makes us tired. So it's basically the opposite of caffeine.
Und
okay. The caffeine basically goes to the transmitter,
but
instead of adenosine, it doesn't do anything at this point. So all of these things that happen when you're tired don't happen. So instead, we become more awake, we become more active, we become happy.
Kommt dann auch noch ein bisschen darauf an, wie genau.
And that also, wie unser Körper so funktioniert. The caffeine also happens works differently depending on how our body works. For older people, caffeine works more because it goes to the proteins in your blood, and older people have less proteins, whereas someone who's smoking, they will eliminate the caffeine more quickly, because the enzymes that are eliminating the caffeine are higher concentrated in people who are smoking. And if you use contraception, hormonal contraception, or are pregnant, then it's completely the opposite. So your elimination is smaller. It's also interesting that if you have ADHD, you might have a paradox effect of caffeine. So it was something that I found on the internet, but I've also found some research that would suggest this, because ADHD also works on the neurotransmitters like adrenaline. So if we have something that makes sure, so if with ADHD you have something that leads to dopamine being more released, then this caffeine could also have a different effect. So it's possible that it is, but we haven't really, there's not really a lot of evidence. So if we consume too much caffeine, then we kind of get side effects. Now when I drink a mate, I might not be able to sleep. Now, if I actually drink too much, we can become nervous, we can not be able to sleep, we can sweat a lot, we can be kind of nervous, our heart rate quickens, and everything of that is like what happens when we're too awake. So our body kind of feels we have too much energy, and this energy needs to go somewhere. So maybe we even get panic attacks. But the most serious side effect, long-standing side effect, is actually that that you get a tolerance, so you get used to it, and your body will react if you don't give him the caffeine. So let's talk about the mass of caffeine. So what's much caffeine? What's little caffeine? So actually, the Federal Institute for Risk Taking has some guidelines for adults. They will suggest that you should not take more than 200 milligrams of caffeine at one time, which is 2 club mates, and you shouldn't take more than 400 milligrams caffeine per day, so not more than 5.7 milligrams per kg body weight. If you're underage, because caffeine works in the central nervous system, you should only take 3 milligrams per 1 kg body weight per day, actually. This is quite interesting for kids who are about 33 kg heavy, they can actually take one mate per day. And if you're pregnant, you should take about half of other adults.
Also höchstens.
So at most, obviously.
Das Kind in dem Fall nicht irgendwelche gesundheitlichen
Beeinträchtigungen. So that the child won't have any problems.
200 Milligramm pro Tag.
In general, it's like 200 milligrams per day, which I think is quite a lot. Because there's a lot of outrage when pregnant people are drinking caffeine, but actually it's their decision, right? Okay. Caffeine in the long term will make new synapses for adenosine. There's like our bodies in balance usually.
Irgendwie wird das ganze Adenosin nicht abgebaut.
So after a while,
neue Synapsen. Das heißt,
when you take more caffeine, you will get more synapses.
Adenosin sich abgebaut hat.
So if we want
und schlafen, viel schlafen.
If we want to kind of like stay the same, we need to take more caffeine suddenly. Or, you know, not take any caffeine and then wait for the adenosine to get eliminated and sleep, basically. So what will happen when we don't drink any caffeine, we will actually become tired. Now many people, including me, thinks that caffeine in the morning is actually great. Who of you drank caffeine within the first hour of getting up today?
Leider werden wir nicht schläfrig und dann super fit wie diese Katze.
Unfortunately, we don't become tired and then very fit like this cat. Instead, we have another hormone in our body, cortisol. Cortisol in the morning has its peak like 1 hour after we get up. There's this peak and we're suddenly awake. Then we can't improve this situation. So, but if we do this in the long term, then in the morning, our body will think, well, I won't need to actually produce this cortisol. So that leads to our body basically expecting us to drink caffeine.
Deswegen ist so, bis nach einer Stunde nach
you should not take caffeine until an hour after you've gotten up. Here I say between 8 and 9 a.m. and this kind of assumes that you get up at 8 a.m. Who of you got up at 8 or a.m. or earlier today? Oh, quite a lot actually. Quite surprising.
Respekt an euch.
Respekt.
Jedenfalls haben wir noch
okay, anyway,
12 und 13 Uhr einen Koffeinpeak
between 12 und
Entschuldigung,
13 between 12 haben, and 1 p.m. we also have a cortisol peak and between 5:30 and 6:30 p.m. So if you have Mate with you, please drink it now.
So, angenommen, wir sind jetzt an dem Punkt, an dem wir
so, let's assume we are at the point where we don't want to consume caffeine any longer, and then we're standing in front of our mate and are kind of sad, and maybe we want to take it, but maybe if we don't do it, we are actually in withdrawal, which is the minimum of 12 hours, and it can be up to 9 days, usually it's around 2 days, and it leads to headaches, and we're tired, we lose energy, we are moody, we might not be the happiest at that point in time. Possibly we also have an increase in appetite, which is because caffeine is making us energized, and this is going down if we stop taking it. And you can also have trouble sleeping, which is kind of surprising. There is a study from 2003 which describes all the effects which happen if you stop taking caffeine, and there was also a note on nightmares, actually. And there's also this funny website on the internet where you can check your dose for caffeine, which is from the official
Bundeszentrum for so an official German institution which is trying to tell us what is healthy for you and what is not. So I clicked around on this web page, and you can select how much caffeine you are taking and what's your age and your body weight and the time span where you drank it and whether you drank it all at once or throughout the day. And you can choose a couple of drinks here, for example, black tea, green tea, coffee, espresso, chocolate, which you eat. So I clicked around there a bit and I was like, what is happening here? What is it calculating? And I got a lot of different results here, so I was kind of interested and I looked at the source code and found JavaScript. So that's kind of interesting because
in sich selbst inkonsistent.
It's kind of inconsistent, the code. So, because the numbers of how much caffeine is in there, there is sometimes the concentration per 100 milliliters,
Milligramm pro 100 Milliliter,
which is milligram per 100 milliliters, and in other cases it's per cup, which I find kind of weird.
Eine Tasse ist keine,
because a cup is not a defined unit, so it's not really clear how much it actually is. So also it doesn't include whether a person is above or under 18, so there is different variations in the calculation. I'm sorry I didn't format the code here correctly. If you're very interested in it, you can look at the code yourself. It's not very nice. And also there is a randomization of the responses. So if you're on the edge, you can get a note saying attention, or this is at the edge. So it's kind of funny, actually. But also, as this website is talking about, sometimes it can be too much caffeine. So let's talk about the deadly dose of caffeine, which is far away from the 400 milligrams we were talking about earlier, which is 10 whole grams. So the question here becomes, where is caffeine in the things we consume? So if I look at this Floramate, that's around 100 milligrams of caffeine, so that would be a lot of Floramate. So I went to my Hackspace and looked at the fridge, and I looked at the Mate fridge, and we have also drinks like beer, because that's like a basic thing we also have, and we also have drinks without caffeine. And so I started looking at what kinds of drinks we have there, and in our storage we have 137 liters of Mate, and I was looking at how much caffeine is in the different types of Mate, and it's 27.65 grams of caffeine. So and then I also looked at the fridge, which is 28 liters of Mate, which concludes to 5.78 grams of caffeine. So in total that's 165 liters of Mate and 33.43 grams of caffeine. So that would be 55 liters of Mate for a lethal dose of caffeine. That would be a lot to drink. The body will shut this down, not just because of the caffeine, but for a lot of other reasons. So getting an overdose of caffeine on accident is super difficult. And so another question is, where else do we find caffeine? Because like obviously we can drink Mate and we can drink coffee, but are there other stuff, like foods we consume, which include caffeine? And I walked around by a flat and saw what I could find. And I, for example, found chocolate, where you might be surprised to find caffeine. So here we have a list of stuff you might usually consume where you find caffeine. So the thing I personally find most interesting is chocolate, but to get to these numbers, I can actually drink a lot of Mate. I'm more happy to drink a Floramate than eat 5 bars of milk chocolate, even though that would also be nice. But
Kaffee ist nochmal so ein kleiner Sonderfall.
Coffee is kind of a special case.
Es kommt immer so ein bisschen darauf an, wie stark der Kaffee gemacht
ist. It depends on how strong the coffee is.
Auf der GPN,
last year at GPN,
which is another hacker event,
we had a coffee machine and we filled it up to the limit, so it barely closed. So that was maybe a bit more caffeine, but in other cases, if you put less coffee in your coffee, so less coffee pulver in your coffee, then it might be a bit weaker. But just looking at the laws, there are also limits. So there is this limit of 15 milligrams per 100 milliliters, and there is this warning which is saying not for children or pregnant people, and this is because of the laws which are telling the producers to put this label on their products. And a lot of companies actually put this label on drinks where they don't need to, but they are doing it anyways. And for energy drinks, this is actually a different limit than for coffee. And for energy drinks, it's a maximum of 32 milliliters per 100 milliliters. And there is also special caffeinated products, so food which would not include caffeine on its own, or stuff which have additionally added caffeine, for example this Koa Watch, but also jellies or specially caffeinated chocolate which has more caffeine than regular chocolate. There's chewing gum, there's caffeine tablets actually. I'm actually studying chemistry. One person there is eating caffeine tablets with red wine, but especially with caffeine tablets and coffee, you can actually go to your limits a little bit. It's not quite lethal most of the time, but it can become dangerous.
Ich würde mal sagen höchstens 80 Milligramm auf 100 Milliliter.
So a regular coffee is like 80 milligrams per 100 milliliters, but some coffee beans are actually stronger in caffeine than just regular ones.
Auf die 85 Milligramm
where you can easily get to 58 milligrams per 100 milliliters, but isn't a ton, but like it's getting more. And there is this Black Insomnia coffee, which is the strongest coffee I could find, which is 311 milligrams per 100 milliliters. And it was a bit confusing to find this out, because a lot of the producers are saying this amount of caffeine per cup, and as I just talked about earlier, a cup is not the best unit of measurement because there are tiny cups and small cups, so that can mean a lot of things if you put this measurements by cup. And at some point I found out a cup is 177 milliliters, which is from the US, because they don't like metric measuring systems. And another thing you might have heard about is caffeine against hair loss, which is like, hey, caffeine can help my body, but can it also help my hair? And can my hair grow stronger or better or faster? Or is there any kind of cool effect? And there's actually studies on this, which have a positive effect in the laboratory, which is for a specific case for hair loss, which is due to genetics. And for people who have this special genetic case, they mix testosterone and caffeine and put the substance in there, and
so they put the hair in there for 5 days, and I don't think most of us actually wash their hair for a 5 whole days. And in the UK, there is a shampoo which has been limited to advertise. They were advertising for this to reduce hair loss, but like they were limited to do this advertising because there's not really a scientific proof here. And then I was also asking myself, how much caffeine do we consume worldwide? And I found a lot of stats about coffee. So I specifically looked at these stats about coffee, which I could find. So I found out in Finland, people consume a lot of coffee, and a lot of Scandinavian countries are doing quite well. Germany is kind of in the middle here.
Prognose, wie sie für das Jahr 2007 war.
Is
2017. Sorry.
For 2017, but it's not the stats, but like.
Haben, warum das so toll ist. Is it in Finnland und Schweden gibt es
actually.
Das ist so eine Art von Kaffeepause. Also es ist auch, es ist nicht nur eine Kaffeepause.
And in Finland there is this concept of fika, which is kind of a coffee break, but it's like so not just a coffee break we know, which is just like taking a coffee and like chilling, but it's also a form of socializing. So due to this fika, this is a reason why there is this high consume of coffee in the Scandinavian countries. In Iceland, it's apparently the national drink, but I didn't really find stats on this. And apparently, coffee is not only known on our planet, but also on the USS Voyager, where the captain is flying to different kinds of planets to find more coffee. And I was like, yeah, well, coffee is all right, but I myself, I don't consume a lot of coffee, so I prefer Mate. And how is the consumption for Mate worldwide? So Mate, the original substance, is from South America, but the iced tea we have here is originating in Germany, which was known as Sektbrunte, which is produced by the brewery Loscher. And we could actually visit the Mate brewery at the International Club Mate Party. And this brewery on their website is saying they export to 75 companies worldwide to Madagascar and China. So maybe Club Mate is being exported worldwide, and like I think this is mostly specific for Club Mate.
I'm currently talking a lot about how much caffeine and how can we measure this? And it would be kind of cool to have some sort of fluid or something else that would allow us to find out how much caffeine is in there. So like a litmus test, basically. That would be amazing. But unfortunately, it's not that easy. There is a Murexit test, which allows us to show to find caffeine, basically. But unfortunately, we can also find other stuff like urea.
Aus dem Bereich der Harnsäure.
And it's usually it was found to find urea, actually. So if you use this test, then you can actually find urea in your urine. But unfortunately, it's not very easy to actually carry it out because you need very specific chemicals, and then it becomes violet once you find it. And then we also don't know what is the limit for finding it. So maybe we can't even find our caffeine. So that would be an easy solution. But how do all of the producers find out how much caffeine is in there? So the good answer is there is a possibility, but it's not very easy. There is a lab
Chromatographie.
HPLC, which is like a high power liquid chromatograph, which which allows a lot of chemists to not have to work as much. Basically, I put some stuff in there and then just easily, just very basic. Sorry, I haven't found a picture of a more recent OS. I've already stood in front of this device at university, and I think I kind of just tried to forget what kind of OS there was. So yeah, because those devices are very expensive, they just use whatever OS works with this software. So basically what this does is it separates stuff. And there's an experiment that schools like to do. So we use a filter paper and put a hole in there and then kind of allow this paper to be separated into pen to be separated into its constituting elements. And this is the same thing we do with this HPLC. We have one matter and we modify it a little bit. So in order to do that, we use different solutions, and one of them is a calibrating solution. And because for this calibrating solution, we actually know the concentration of whatever active ingredient we want to test for. And this is what we use for our internal standard. This is, this internal standard is something that is similar to the stuff that we want to analyze, which allows us to make sure that we don't make as many mistakes, basically. And if anything in this internal standard changes, then we know that our actual stuff is also probably changing. So if we use something that is similar to the caffeine, then we have suddenly done this with this calibration solution. At which point we have this solution of whatever with caffeine, and then this allows us to separate this solution into different smaller solutions, and sometimes we can use different methods as well, where molecules are split apart, and then you can look what is actually in these molecules. And it's actually quite a complicated topic, but the idea is we separate this into different molecules, and then we are able to see what is in there. Okay, so this was it. I hope you've learned something about caffeine. I'll upload these slides later. So if you have any questions, just ask them right now. Thank you for your attention.
Alles klar.
Okay.
Vielen Dank soweit, Lea.
Thank you, Lea. We have about 13 minutes for questions and answers. So if you have questions, just head up to the microphones. There's one on the left and one on the right. And we'll be able to answer your questions, or Lea will be able to answer your questions. There's no questions, apparently.
Als hätte der Vortrag bereits alle Fragen beantwortet.
Okay, wenn wir noch Zeit haben. Was ist eure Lieblingsmate-Sorte?
Okay, if we still have time, what's your favorite Mate? What's your favorite Mate?
Mal ganz kurz, also es gibt ja eigentlich nur zwei auf dem Kongress. Wer mag denn Flora Power lieber? Mal kurz Hand hoch.
Who prefers Flora Power? Hands are shown. Who prefers Club Mate?
Das ist relativ gleich.
It's roughly unanimous. Maybe a little more Flora Power.
Wer mag eine andere Mate lieber?
Who prefers another kind of Mate?
Ich sehe schon, wir müssen irgendwie an der Mate-Pluralität auf den Chaos-Veranstaltungen
arbeiten. Need to have more different Mate.
Wir haben noch eine Frage gefunden. Bitte schön.
We do have a question now.
Hi. Es gibt immer das Gerücht, ich weiß, ich habe noch nie.
There's a rumor.
Dass man, wenn man irgendwie nur eine Woche oder so kein Koffein,
if you don't drink caffeine
for a week, auf null hat, oder vielleicht waren es auch zwei
then your tolerance will go down to zero. So between in a very, very short time. I can imagine that it's a very short time because most of these withdrawal symptoms are done within 2 days. Of course, sometimes it can take a little longer, but usually it's only 2 weeks. So after 9 days at most, your withdrawal is done. So I would assume that even your tolerance will be done after 9 days.
Also ja, diese Entzugserscheinungen sind dann weg, aber die Frage wäre, du hast ja gesagt, es bilden sich dann noch mehr Nervenzellen und Synapsen.
Yes, the withdrawal symptoms are done, but the synapses are... what about the synapses that have...
meine Idee ist, also diese Synapsen
appeared. Well, yeah, of course someone else can say something, but maybe my idea is that these synapses are kind of... appearing very quickly, so they might be able to disappear very quickly as well.
Sieht nicht so aus, vielleicht.
Okay, doesn't look like it. Maybe next Congress, there's will follow up.
Wie gesagt, ich bin nicht der Weiße als letzter Schluss. Wenn ihr irgendetwas findet, womit ihr mich über Koffein genauer informieren könnt, bitte her damit. Also ihr könnt mir auch sehr gerne Nachrichten über Koffein schreiben, wenn ihr das möchtet.
Like I'm not the only expert here. If you have any more information about caffeine and you want to inform me about this, just send me a message. Thank you, Leah, for this talk. We did a quick